There are so many amazing things in the universe that are truly worth seeing. With the advancement in high-resolution telescopes, today these things are more accessible than ever. Humans have sent spacecrafts to the farthest reaches of our solar system. They have showed us images that are never seen before. Some of these images are inspiring for their beauty and remoteness, while others help us understand our tiny place in the universe. Here are top 10 astronomical pictures everyone needs to see. A close-up view of Pluto. Before 2015, the very best image of the dwarf planet Pluto was smudgy and blurry, and didn't reveal a whole lot about the composition of this little world. When the New Horizons spacecraft flew past Pluto, it revealed that Pluto wasn't just some boring ball of rock and ice, after all. It was a geographically dynamic world. Its mostly smooth surface suggests that its crust has been constantly reshaping itself, erasing impact craters. Astronomers even speculate there may be a slushy sea underneath Pluto's heart-shaped basin. The image above is the highest resolution image from the New Horizons mission, which was launched in 2006 and arrived at Pluto in 2015. This image instantly became an iconic image of Pluto. What it's like on the surface of Pluto. Here's another image from the New Horizons mission, and this one is my favorite. It's a close-up view of Pluto's surface, captured just 15 minutes after New Horizons' closest approach to the planet. It shows 11,000-foot-tall mountains and icy plains. You can even see tiny wisps of Pluto's extremely thin atmosphere in arch-shaped lines above the surface. This photo helps us understand what it would be like to be there on the surface. Pluto may be a dwarf planet, but it's an entirely different world. Jaw-dropping images of Jupiter. On July 4, 2016, NASA's Juno spacecraft arrived at Jupiter, traveling at a blistering speed of 130,000 miles per hour. Since then, it has been orbiting the largest planet in our solar system. The Juno spacecraft has revealed many secrets. It includes enormous new cyclones swirling around the planet's poles, a magnetic field that's much more variable than expected, a belt of ammonia encircling Jupiter's equator, and some evidence that Jupiter's core is not as dense and compact as once thought. Juno has delivered beautiful portraits of Jupiter. Jupiter's clouds have a stormy, gauzy quality, like cream swirling in the largest imaginable cup of coffee. Add to that the awesome size of what's in them, even small details on Jupiter can be larger than the entire Earth. Consider this image of Jupiter's great red spot. You could fit three Earths inside its vortex. The very first image of a black hole. In April 2019, an international collaboration of scientists called the Event Horizon Telescope told the world that, for the first time, humanity has peered into the edge of a black hole. The supermassive black hole is at the center of the M87 galaxy, which is 53 million light-years away. The black hole is called M87. It is massive, about 6.5 billion times the mass of our Sun, all contained in a single point of infinite density. In the image, the visible reddish and white light surrounding the black hole is material being destroyed by its immense gravity. That light encircles the photon orbit, a region beyond which light could escape from, but is unlikely to. Within that photon orbit is the event horizon, the region beyond which no light can escape. As you look at this image, you can feel that this isn't an ordinary object. This is literally a heart of darkness. The light in the center gets sucked out of our view. The absence in the image means that something has left our observable universe. It's a truly remarkable moment for humans to be able to see something so enigmatic, so far away, and so incredibly difficult to capture. Stars orbiting the black hole in the center of our galaxy. The image of M87 shows what a black hole's event horizon looks like. This video is a testament to the amazing power of black holes. This video is a 20-year time-lapse of observations from the European Southern Observatory's telescope. It shows the stars in an orbit around the black hole, at the center of our own galaxy. This black hole is called Sagittarius A. The stars in this video are more massive than our Sun. Like our planet orbits the Sun, these stars are orbiting the black hole. You can't see the black hole in this video, but look at the center of the video to see a star doing a complete loop around an empty bit of space. One of the stars in this array, called S2, recently passed by the black hole at a speed greater than 15.5 million miles per hour. That's more than 4,300 miles every second, or nearly 3% of the speed of light. Scientists recently used this observation in a test to prove, once again, that Albert Einstein's theory of gravity is correct. Hubble catches an interstellar visitor. This is a recent image of a comet that is passing through our solar system. It was born around a star that is not our own, then flung off into space by some unknown cataclysm. But it's not here to stay. It's moving at around 100,000 miles per hour, which is much too fast for even our mighty sun to capture it in its orbit. For reference, Voyager 1, the spacecraft that has left our solar system, is traveling at around 35,000 miles per hour. The comet is the second interstellar object recorded in our solar system. The first interstellar object was discovered in 2017. It was a cigar-shaped rock, which drove scientists crazy. The above image was taken on November 16. The bright blue object in the center is the comet, approximately 203 million miles away from Earth. The smudgy object to the left of it is actually a spiral galaxy, which is about 390 million light years away from us. How's that for an extreme contrast in scale? The core of the comet is probably less than a mile wide. The Rosetta mission delivered a serene portrait of a comet. The European Space Agency's Rosetta mission was the first to actually land a probe onto the surface of a comet. The mission was launched in 2004 and arrived at the comet in 2014. The comet is 2.5 miles wide. It's amazing that we could navigate to something so small in the vastness of space. The above image, captured in 2015, shows the comet in stunning detail. In the area outlined by the circle, scientists discovered a tiny chunk of material actually orbiting the comet. It's like a teeny tiny moon. Perhaps even more exciting is this close-up time-lapse of the surface of the comet. It's almost cinematic. In the foreground, dust and cosmic rays look like a snowstorm. And you can clearly see the craggy features of the comet. It makes it easier to imagine what it's like to take a ride on a comet. A view of the Earth from Saturn. This will probably be remembered as the most famous image from the Cassini mission. It's a picture of the Earth, as seen from the dark side of Saturn. The cursor on the image points out the Earth. We're just a speck of dust, suspended in a sunbeam. Hubble's extreme deep field reminds us how impossibly large the universe is. Everywhere in the universe we look, there are vast discoveries to be found. This image was captured by the Hubble's extreme deep field observation. The image is the result of combining 1,000 exposures of a teeny tiny patch of sky, taken over 10 years. The image contains 5,500 galaxies found in a portion of the night sky that's smaller than 1/10th width of the moon. This is just a 30 millionth of the whole sky. So in every thumbnail-sized area of the sky, there's untold numbers of galaxies, stars, planets, and possibly life. It's mind-boggling and scary at the same time. Birth of a new solar system. In 2014, the Radio Alma Observatory captured this amazing image of a star, which is about 450 light-years away from Earth. The star is at the center of the image, but surrounding it are rings of material, left over from the birth of the star. Like the planet Saturn has rings, stars can have rings, too. Looking at the image, astronomers have found evidence that planets are forming out of the material in those rings. This is the beginning of an entirely new solar system. It is perhaps not so different than ours. When we look at the birth of this solar system, we're looking at a process that likely birthed our own solar system.